the first triangle, because you had 20 megalithic rods on the east-west line, that makes 50 megalithic yards. I thought it could be the side of a 3-4-5 triangle, which would have 30 by 40 by 50 megalithic yards. And so I cleared out the vegetation, and I got to this spot. This was covered, totally covered, with brambles and these very spiky things, nothing visible. And I cleared it away, and I discovered this stone here, which now is quite clear because I brought quite a lot of people here, and now this stone has become well known, so lots of people come and see it. But I don't know how deep it goes, because, you know, I haven't done, the archaeologists won't pay any attention to it, and so there's been no dig of any kind around it. But if you look along this side of the stone, you see how it aims exactly at the corner. You can see how this side aims exactly to the corner of the recumbent stone there. Mm-hmm. And if you come on this side and you look along this angle, you see how it points straight to the standing stone.
Mm. So we have another right triangle.
Right, and the right angle is actually marked out by a square.
On the stone.
Exactly. The stone actually does exactly what we would do if we were drawing a triangle. It puts the square in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So the square is exactly in the corner. And now, of course, what's interesting is that here it's 30 by 40 by 50 megalithic yards. Professor Thom never knew about this, so you have a perfect example of the use of the megalithic yard in units of 10 megalithic yards on a 3-4-5 triangle.
Mm. Fabulous.
It's what's incredible, isn't it, is that this stone was put here maybe 6,500 years ago, and it hasn't moved.
It certainly suggests that some archaeological digging around here would be quite interesting.
Well,
because, obviously a lot of people were spending time here, and so there would have been...
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. You see here, this stone here, that marks north-south. So I wouldn't be at all surprised if you cleared all this away, if stones weren't tracing out a whole load of geometrical things under the ground.
Mm.
But of course this is totally abandoned. It's private land. Mm-hmm. To clear it out, I asked I phoned up the people who own it, they live in a chateau south of here. They have lots and lots of forest land in the area. They said, no problem. As long as you don't cut any trees down. So I cleared out all the bushes and just so we could see them. But there really, really should be a proper cleaning of the whole area, and the whole thing should be, you know, you should clear away everything that's come covered over the initial plan.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Well, that's fascinating.
So I actually have made with a rope, I have made a 12 knotted rope in units of 10 megalithic yards. And I do come here with people and do it. I did it for the BBC. Mm-hmm. I did a thing for the BBC on the coast, and I brought them here, and I brought the string, I brought the rope, and we laid it out, and they could see the 10 to 20. Yeah. And they cut it out from the...
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah, it wasn't in the program. They showed other stuff, but they wouldn't show that. I think it's too... It puts too many things into question, you see. And another very... What I was interested in after your work on the Plimpton 322 Sumerian tablet, is the fact that here you find a triangle through the geometry, which is in that table, which is the 119, 120, 169.
Where do you see that one?
That's in the table of the Sumerian.
No, that's the first one, yeah. Yes. But where is it here?
It's QRO, so it's the relationship between the center of, right, it's a bit more complicated. There's a kind of circle. If I link the standing stone to the corner of the quadrilateral and I trace the center of that circle, I get a point O. And that point O, the point, the corner of the quadrilateral, that is a 119, 120, 169 triangle. Okay, so it's the relationship between the corner of the quadrilateral, the standing stone, and the center, it's its position on the circle, in fact.
Of course, that's almost a 45, yeah. 90 triangle.
So almost. Yeah, almost, yeah. Yeah, but not exactly.
But and not it's, exactly.
And the geometry can be quite clearly seen. And that's the, in fact, that angle is the double of a 5, 12, 13 triangle. The angle of that specific triangle is the double.
Yeah. Or in terms of spreads, we would say if you take the second spread polynomial on that and you get,
Yeah, well, I haven't adapted.
You haven't adapted rational trigonometry. Okay, that's next step.
So if we come back to this thing here, so we've seen the doorway here, the entrance to the quadrilateral with the two bigger stones, that what is called in French la dame du manio, the lady of the manio, which is the sort of stomach-shaped recumbent stone, the giant stone, and then the square stone, which we have here. And that enables us to see how this geometry works. But then the other interesting thing is that between the Dame du Manio and the Géant du Manio, if we go to the top right-hand corner of the quadrilateral, that is positioned with respect to two 5, 12, 13 triangles, which create the exact halfway point between on the east-west line between the giant and the dame. Yeah. Mm. Okay?
Nice.
So I explained all that in a short period of time, but it took quite a lot of years, really, to come up with all that. And this is summer solstice sunrise here, because it's the 3-4-5 triangle in the other direction, so I've got the photo of that. That's the equinox. That's the equinox photo where you've got the flat side and the giant here. It's very difficult in the woods. The sun has risen a bit, but if you put it down to its beginning, it's perfect east-west. There it is. That's this stone here. Mm-hmm. There's the standing stone. The sun's risen a bit because it comes up right on the line there. Mm. Yeah. Summer solstice. Right. I've managed to get a photo of the whole thing. That's a wide angle photo where you see the standing stone, the square.
Mm-hmm.
And that's east-west. Okay. Of course, with the wide angle, that doesn't look like it's a square.
Yeah. 6,000 years ago.
Yeah.
Fabulous.